we treat in Helsinki University Hospital with navigated TMS about 7 pain patients per day. And it varies from 5 to 7, but the typical number is 7. Patients we are treating come to our department from the outpatient pain clinic. And the patients are typically patients with chronic neuropathic pain and drug-resistant pain. And typical patient groups are post-stroke pain patients, facial pain patients, and complex regional pain syndrome patients, and phantom limb pain patients. Our target for the treatment is primary motor cortex. That is our first target always, and we give at least 5 days to that target. And if we get some benefit from that target, we continue another week to the same target. That is our intensive treatment period, like 2 weeks totally. And if we do not benefit from, if patients do not benefit from that target in the first week, then we change the target for next week to secondary somatosensory cortex, contralateral to side of pain. And if patient get some benefit from that target, then we continue 5 more days to that target. And then we have a maintenance treatment if patient benefits, and the maintenance treatment, the duration of maintenance treatment is typically 6 months. And per day, the treatment session takes 15 minutes. So we give 3,000 pulses, and we give 100 pulses in 10 seconds, so meaning we use 10 hertz stimulation frequency, and with the inter-trial interval of 20 seconds. Our experience about the navigated RTMS treatment is that about half of the patients get benefit, meaning that the pain scores decrease about 30% or more during the treatment period. And our patients are very motivated. We do not have really problems to get patients into this therapy. I think in the future, the RTMS therapy for pain patients will be more common. At the moment, it is already in Finland, it is used in all university hospitals, but I believe that also internationally it will be more common part of the treatment of pain patients. And I think that in the future it will be more personalized, a way that it's tailored based on the perhaps the type or etiology of the pain. I think in the future we will use much more tailored target selection, that where to give the RTMS therapy in the which cortical target for each patient.